I want to tell you first who we are, the German Biochar Association, what our is our vision and mission. I want to tell you a little bit about the EBC facts, because we want to cooperate with EBC much more closer, as I will show you later. And I also want to tell you a little bit about our international conference we are planning in November, and of the other things we are doing actually. So, who we are? We are a really youngster in the association world. We were founded in February 2017. We were made up from users, farmers, biochar producers, carbonization technology producers, and engineers, and also scientists. I think this is compared with the IBI, a really different thing, because IBI, as I learned, started with a scientist, with the scientist, the academic approach. And we started with this practical approach, because we think it is really important to bring biochar in the whole community, not only in the academic context, but also in practical use. We have in 1 year got 75 members, actually, round about. They are also from Austria, not only from Germany, Austria like Gerhard Dunst, or Switzerland, Hans-Peter Schmidt, or Serbia, you learned see Balz Bauer yesterday. He's also a member in our association. And in 2018, we thought, because we have a lot of black sheep on the biochar market in actually, who sell cheap biochar, not regarding the certification or the pollution of the biochar, we decided to design a code of ethics for all our members. In this code of ethics, we want to make sure that everybody who is inclined with our association does it with the right heart to it. Yeah, my person, I'm the director of this association. It is only because I was the person who said, okay, I think we need to have to get together. We working together, we have to put your strength and your knowledges together to achieve our targets in the future. So my personal background is I'm a civil engineer, and my main task is material flow management, also in the municipality context. So biochar was last link I got to make a really good circular economy, and therefore I engage in a lot of commissions. Perhaps you know the VDI working groups, where we work together with Claudia Kammann to establish the emission reduction targets when we use several kinds of biomass carbonization. And there I learned that the hydrochar community, which produce a completely different kind of char, as Bruno mentioned before, they were organized already in a big association. They sampled a lot of money, even they had no really plant working, actually, as I know. But if you know otherwise, you can say it. And we had a lot of confusion in Germany, because we did a lot of scientists did a lot of research concerning HTC, hydrothermal carbonization, and as you learned, the carbon is completely different. The biochar, they say it is biochar, but it is not useful for the soil, and it is also not useful for sequestration rates. So I thought it is really important to say we make completely different things if we do pyrolysis or this thermal carbonization. In our advisory committee, we have people to ensure that we do the right things, that we address the right topics. You learned Claudia Kammann, yeah? You heard also Dr. or Professor Gerhard Zuja. You learned about Gerald Dunst. Hans-Peter Schmidt is also known international with his Ithaca Institute. Thomas Unkelbach is a farmer from Germany. He's also a practitioner, and Daniel Cray is also from the academic side. And I think what is also really important that we involved the politician side with Matthias Ginter and also with one politician from the Christian Democratic Party in Germany, this Martin von Marschall, because we have to do some lobby work to get the biochar idea spread. Our vision and our mission. The Tim Flannery, a scientist from Australia, said a lot of years, 12 years ago, that biochar may represent the single most important initiative for humanity's environmental future. And I think this is really true said, because this is also a simple technology. You could do it low-tech or high-tech. Everybody could be involved in this technology to help save our future. So our vision really is to involve everybody, and from the farmers, gardeners, and citizens, to restock the carbon storage in soils and generates an income, because it is also important to make it valuable, economic valuable. When we can achieve this, we will get a future where our groundwater is clean or much cleaner than today. Livestock breeding is free of antibiotics, and global warming is reduced. I once said we could make a slogan for biochar worldwide, say, cool down. That's because this is our vision, what we want to achieve. I think the really important thing is that we could involve everybody. People also who actually have the feeling that they are standing outside the society. We could get involved in the biochar community and give them a simple approach to have their share in solving the problems we have to face concerning the climate change, actually. And perhaps this could heal also our social problems we have with, with special parties in politics, which are all shouting they want to go back in history. But this is not the conclusion and the solution. Yeah, so what we are doing is, where we are involved and what we support is beneath the agriculture and science issues, also the politics, and as we heard, regulatory authorities are a really big part we have to address. Because there are so much, I don't want to say stupidity, too less knowledge about the systems and soils, so that we have to deal with regulatory authorities, which, stop the developments and the bright future we want to achieve only by being headstrong, hanging on our other things which they say would be great. Yeah, and therefore we try to make a really offensive press work. Yeah? We decided to plan the good part of our membership fees in public relations affairs to go outside of our community, of our small close community, get people involved from every part of community and tell them what for biochar would be a really great thing. You saw in our name that there is written Pflanzenkohle. Yeah, that's because the name biochar in Germany has this spoiled thing that you only mix it every time with this ATC charcoal, so we have to separate a little bit from this. And yeah, with this word Pflanzenkohle, this is also confusing for normal people, because you have to explain why is it like this, why is it called Pflanzenkohle, because you could use other things theoretically which are not from plants to produce some charcoal, some biochar, perhaps bones. This is not what we want to use in our community, but it could be. So what do we need to get more forward is the adjustment of the fertilizer regulation. Yeah? As we learned from Gerald, there are some confusions in several country situations. In Germany we have the problem that untreated bio-organic waste materials are not actually allowed as a feedstock for biochar production, but we must change this, because only then we can get the local potentials in cycles, in closed cycles, and establish the cycle economy that our politics are every time asking for. But on the other side, they put a lot of stones in our ways to hinder us to do so. Yeah, and also what would be a great success if we could get the acceptance of biochar on a positive list for the organic farming, also in Germany. In Switzerland, this goal is already achieved. We have this for organic farming, but only when the biochar has the feedstock of wood. So perhaps we could improve this also in the future. We need also public funding for fundamental research. As we heard, we had a lot of different types of biochar, and each type of biochar has his sides, yeah? His negative and positive sides, and the approach where we can use it really for the whole best of its benefit. But we have to find out, we have to characterize, we have to distribute it in our community all over the world, what kind of feedstock would be and kind of plant, you know, or planting plant process would be great to get this kind of biochar we need for our project. So also the financial incentive for the application of biochar as a means for global cooling would be good if we would have there a really financial deal for the CO2 certificates. What Gerald actually does on this private way we need in the public way in politics all over the world to get steps further and further. So, come to the EBC facts. The new activity after 1 year established is that we committed to administrate the EBC European Biochar Certificate. So we only become the program holder of the EBC. That means that we maintain the web page, that we collect and process and coordinate the suggestions of everybody made to the scientific committee. So you see, if you have an idea or a thought how we could improve the EBC, you could come to us, mention your arguments and we would bring them to the scientific committee so they can decide if this suggestion is really an improvement or would be spoiling our UBC, because it is really necessary that we don't water it. Yeah? It must be clear and make it proof that we only have a good quality of biochar. Yeah, we also will organize the scientific committee meetings, and we are hardly looking for more laboratories which are able to test the biochar with these advanced testing systems which were specially developed in the EPC testing biochar. But later for that, yeah. And to make it clear, if we have found other laboratories, we have to make it clear that the results, the different results, are comparable, because the different laboratories will all work with the same methods here. Yeah, and also what we are developing actually is some suggestions for new certificates. Because we have, as we mentioned before, different kinds of biochar with different kinds of use possible. And so we wouldn't need, if we, for example, think of wastewater clearing the same quality we would need for feeding the animals. So it could be some, different characterization of the certificates. Perhaps you know the lean certification of buildings in the US. We have platinum, gold, silver, and bronze for different steps of pureness or reached reached numbers from energy savings. Yeah. We could look to this and decide to create different kind of certification systems. What will be remained at the European Biochar Foundation, which is represented by Hans-Peter Schmidt, would be the management and the selection of the members of the scientific committee, and the final accreditation of certification bodies as well. And he is also he will stay as the issuer of the certificate, and he will always have the last decision, and that he will respect the changes of content of the EPC. So this would not change, and I'm really glad that this is like this. To EBC key facts, you have to look to the chemical analysis and determinations of the thresholds, similar to the IBI. We see that are not so much difference, but there are difference. So if you want to have a clue about the difference, I would recommend you this the homepage of actually the separated homepage of the European Biochar. When you take this link, you will go directly to the tables where you see where the difference are between IBI and EBC. As I mentioned before, these the EBC people, they made the effort to develop a really new special analytical method to especially found the 16 EPA polyaromatic hydrocarbons. To identify them on the char, because in the past, if you gave every kind of biochar to any laboratory, they would say, oh, you don't have any polyaromatic hydrocarbons on your char, because they are sitting so hard on the char, you need really hard measures to put them from the surface and to make the numbers of how much you have on site. So it is really important that you use this kind of analytical method to make it clear that we won't spoil the soil if we use biochar. our enemies, our challengers would be perhaps the better name, always say that we enrich poison substances in the soil if we put biochar inside. So it is really, really important that we do not allow to sell biochar which is not proof, with this substances, that it is clean enough. And also the EBC, it is a difference from the IBI, will also have requirements for the raw material. We support the regional circulation and economy, so we the 80 kilometers are the threshold for the sourcing as a feedstock for the carbonization, and also that untreated raw materials are only used actually. But I think if we do more scientific basic research, we could add in future other materials. But for the beginning, we have to prove that we only have pure materials, not to spoil the soil. As I mentioned before, we have several kinds. We have the EBC certificate, and we have the EBC premium quality. And the EBC premium quality is this quality which is actually allowed for feeding of the animals. We know that the feeding of the animals with charcoals have positive effects on the animal health. As Bals yesterday told us, if the animals are ill, you have these positive effects. If they were healthy, you have some positive effects or not. But you do them no harm with this charcoal. This is proven. But only with this charcoal from wood and activated charcoal. So as a result from this last scientific work, at the moment, we only can use biochar from natural and untreated trunkwood as a feedstock for the animal feed charcoal. And we also have lower thresholds values for the pH contamination when we feed it to the animals. For the animals on the farms, which are going back in the eating circle of people. If you would use it for the animals in our households, I think Dominic will tell you a little bit later in his presentation about the regulations. Glad to hear it. I want to also recommend our international conference in November. We are planning actually with the theme biochar in municipal context on 9 to 10th of November. It will be located in Koblenz. I recommend you Koblenz to visit. It is a really historical place with a lot of castles and so on. But I think we will have also some good speakers for you. Also added to this conference will be a student workshop for PhD students. I placed some papers on the table behind you, call for papers relating to the conference team, unfortunately only in German, but we will soon bring it on our website, also in English, and I would be really glad if somebody of you from this community perhaps could join us there with some topics. Plant speakers actually are Björn Embrenn and Matthias Gustafsson from Stockholm. They showed us last year their Stockholm project was really amazing. Bruno Glaser will also be there. Nikolaus Freudel And also really amazing results from an innovative wastewater treatment process involving biochar would also be showed, because this could be also a really big thing where we could use biochar for public for public use. So other things we also do, I think the lobby work is really important for us. So we are going directly to politicians. 27 minutes, Kathleen, I see it on my slide here. But I'm finished, in 1 minute, We have to contact the politicians. And actually we addressed the CDU, we have addressed the Federal Farming Minister in our new committee, and we also discussed the things with Hans-Josef Fell from the Green Party, because together with Claudia we could convince him that there are really hard difference between HTC and pyrolysis. And we also have some lobbyism profi soon on our side with Evelyn Lemke. She was former Ministry of Rhineland-Palatinate, and she will show us how we do this political lobbying in professional terms. So I think we must go together, we have to work together. We should strengthen the networks worldwide we have actually established, and we've a really strong net all over the world with biochar in the center. And I would really glad if anybody of you here would join us to make this web. Thank you very much.